all, welcome to John's Bottle Making. Today we're carrying on with issues 87 and 88 of the Titanic. Excellent. Now you've seen the port side. For the starboard side. Pop them to one side. There we are, that's the ship up to now. That big window. Now what we'll do at the end of putting these two starboard sections on, we'll get the engine, we'll put that in place, and we'll power it up and we'll have a look at it. Excellent stuff. So let's have a look at the instructions, see what they fully entail. Okie doke, issue 87. Coming in issue 88, the next upper starboard hull section plus screws. In the magazine, Giant of the Sea, Persic, bound for Australia. Oh, lovely pictures. Friendship made on board Persic, the biggest diamond in the world. He looks a bit happy about himself, does he not? There we go. That is the biggest diamond in the world. A resin copy of the Cullinan shows the impressive size of the rough diamond, which was later cut and turned into various gemstones. Never knew that. And there is Queen Mary wearing the crown with a Cullen. Whoops, sorry. Above Queen Mary wearing the crown with a Cullinan 3 in the centre. The right, the great star of Africa setting the sovereign's sceptre. The sceptre of St. Edward's smaller parts of the Cullinan are worn as brooches, pendants and rings. Excellent stuff. And here we have the parts in this issue. Hull section, lower starboard side and LM screws. Yeah, a couple of screws. That is it, a couple of screws. Excellent. Moving on to 88. Let's see what's coming in issue 89. The aft section of the bridge deck with decking and screws. Excellent. That means the bridge deck will be finished. There we have Oceanic, biggest ship in the world. Quite a few pages of that story. There we are. Oh, there we go. There's another menu. Pea soup. Love pea soup. Never had oyster stew. I had lobster once. God, weren't much on it, to be honest. Big lobster and not much meat. I suppose that's the same with all lobsters. Amelia Mary Brown surviving the nightmare. And the next upper starboard hull section. And then we have 7 LM screws. Those are the hexagonal ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we get one spare. And that is what we're left with. Excellent. So without further ado, let's get on with the build. Okay, up here we got the parts. LM screws. Oh, there we go. You can see that curvature again. There we go. That looks brilliant, does it not? Excellent. Couple of screws for here. Onto the ship, so I need to bring the ship into play again. Okay, up here we have the ship, so we just need it basically in that position. There is the panel, looking brilliant. Pop that there like so, and we have 1, 2 LM screws. Hold there, I think it will. We got this screwdriver again, and should be able to pop this in no problem. Excellent, that's the first screw in place. Just a dab of oil as always. Now, gotta make sure we don't bend the ship anymore. Could do with another cross member actually. Which we will get, because you can see where one goes here. But there we go. That's that piece in place. Okie doke, let's show you that piece. Gosh, it's getting big this time. There we go. That's that lower starboard side. We just need the upper side now. Brilliant. There we go. It's massive, is it not? There we go. Right, let's get issue 88 out of its box. Okay, there we got issue 88. There are the LM screws. There we go. There's that upper piece that we can pop into place. Looking brilliant. You can see here, yep, there's actually three more cross members. I'll show you that in a sec, but let's get this into place first. Okay, now we've got the ship back into place. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 screw points. Now this, according to the magazine, should go through here. Oops, there we go, like that, and swing round. But that is a very, very tight fit. That is not going anywhere. So, as in previous issues, recommendation is to slacken off the previous panel, and that should give us some breathing space. And that should be enough, hopefully. Try that again. Get that through there. God, that is being awkward. There we go. That's a lot better. Now we can tighten all these up. Excellent. There we go. Obviously the bottom is loose now. Tighten that up first. That should lock it in place now, that. Hopefully. Better not fall out. Right. That's that bottom panel secured. And that is definitely not coming out. So we need 6 of these LM screws. And I think we'll start with this one. I'm not going to fully tighten them up. Not until we get them all in place. The first one. Okay, let's get the second one in. I didn't think that one wanted to go then, but it's gone in. 3 more screws. Excellent, that's all 6 screws in place. There we go. I'll show you on another camera. There we go. That side of the ship looks absolutely superb, does it not? That looks absolutely brilliant. I'm supporting it as well underneath, because there are 1, 2, 3 more cross members to put in place. That will really stiffen it up. You can see there's 6 of them there. But that was pretty awkward, that. So I'll just loosen that lower panel and then you can get them both in. We've done that before, so it's not too difficult to get done. Now what we can do, we can pop the engine in, and I'll get a better shot on another camera for that. and we can have a look at powering that up and see what it looks like. Okay, there is the ship. This you can see the window there. Pop the engines into place. That can go just there like that. That will sit perfectly like that. I have this hooked up to my laptop. So that's the overhead view. We're on a better view than that really, don't we? There we go. There's a different view for you. There we go. That looks excellent. Brilliant. I haven't put the blades on. But that looks fantastic. There we go, that's the other direction. That's that. Yeah, that's the two outer propellers. There we go. See them rods going up and down? Excellent stuff. And there's the overhead view again. Here we have another angle. Like I said, I've not put the propeller blades on, but everything is looking brilliant. Excellent stuff. Well, there we go guys, that is issues 87 and 88 complete, and the engine is still sat there. Excellent stuff. Yeah, we just need the keel section, don't we, all the way along. But you know what we're getting in 89? We're getting more of the bridge deck. I'm just wondering, yeah this lot is here, the front lot is screwed in from above. Okay, just wondering how we're going to get all the decking together, because if you've noticed by now, the promenade deck, initially you could slide it along. But once you put in the pieces, the bulkheads inside, it stops it from sliding all the way along. So I'm just wondering how we're going to actually fix it all together. I have managed to put mine together, but I actually bent the side of the bridge deck back only slightly, but it went into place. But yeah, it'd be interesting to see what is in the instruction manual. But anyway, you've seen the engines now in place. That looks fantastic. I mean, I do love what some people have done to their engines, coloured them up, painted them differently. They do look superb. I like it as it is, to be honest. But anyway, that is that. So if you did like that, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you next month for the next four issues. Excellent. Thanks for tuning in and watching. Stay safe. Bye for now.